Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. This morning, SpaceX launched another 60 Starlink satellites into orbit with the Starlink 22 mission. The booster which launched, B1060, then landed successfully for the sixth time on the drone ship Of Course I Still Love You. I missed this last week, but SpaceX are constructing a new Octograbber at their Sidco Road facility. If you don't know, SpaceX is constructing a third drone ship which is known as a shortfall of gravitas. Whilst not exactly SpaceX information, this tweet was posted by the FAA which will affect SpaceX in a really good way. They posted the final rule for streamlining the licensing process for commercial launch and re-entry operations is in effect. It enhances innovation, flexibility, efficiency, and public safety in commercial space operations. Ars Technica posted a tweet about an article saying Europe is starting to freak out about the launch dominance of SpaceX. Musk responded with, "They are aiming too low, only rockets that are fully and rapidly reusable will be competitive. Everything else will seem like a cloth biplane in the age of jets." There was a tweet in response saying, "Study competitive launch systems from 2030 onward." Cool. SpaceX will be setting up Mars Base Alpha by then. Musk responded to that and said, "SpaceX will be landing starships on Mars well before 2030. The really hard threshold is making Mars Base Alpha self-sustaining." Over in Boca Chica, construction work continues with the orbital launch pad infrastructure. Here's some other work going on at the orbital launch site. Some new pieces were spotted delivered to the yard. Work on the new mystery structure in the production yard is continuing. They have now begun installing the bridge crane up inside the high bay. Chris B responded to a tweet claiming the first Martian city could begin in 2054. He said, "While we've heard little about it of late, given SpaceX is busy testing the vehicle that will facilitate it, I'm pretty sure Mars Base Alpha's construction start time isn't 2054. Then Musk responded with, "Hopefully will happen this decade." Musk was then asked, "How is Raptor vacuum development and testing going?" He said, "Going well, lot of work for an extra 20 seconds of ISP. Christina Koch posted a picture on Instagram of NASA astronauts next to Starship. She said, "Common goals, shared vision. NASA astronauts learning about the SpaceX Starship, one element in a growing worldwide field of deeper space exploration systems with sites on the Moon and Mars." Adam Bernstein posted a shot of the Nosecone I previously thought might be for SN15 hooked up to a crane. In another great shot by Adam, the nose has also grown by 4 rings as they've stacked it with a section in the yard. Somebody also pointed out that it may have been stacked with an upper dome section. It's possible this could be for Pathfinder reasons related to NASA's Human Lander System competition. The new nose cone in the fabrication tent is getting close to being ready for stacking soon. The new barrel section for this nose is also getting a platform to prepare for stacking. This nose with one flap has also been moved outside now. Some new Starship aerosurface covers were delivered to the yard. Having been stacked in the last video, work continues on the GSE-1 test tank. SpaceX attempted a second static fire of SN11 on Monday and it looked to be successful. They had a closure on Tuesday, but all they did was a short test of the ground systems and Starship. Then they cancelled the closure for today on Tuesday, so we will not see SN11 fly today. Plus, they also cancelled the Thursday closure, so no testing tomorrow either. As of now, there are no road and beach closures scheduled, so we may not even see a launch this week. Along with that, they also had temporary flight restrictions for today and tomorrow, which were also removed. They do, however, still have a TFR for Friday as well as a new TFR added today for Saturday, so there's still a possibility for a launch later this week. Here's Super Heavy, booster number 1 which we saw stacked last episode. This is just going to be a Pathfinder. As always, thank you to Mary, known as Boca Chica Gal, who is out there in Texas filming all the time. Also, thank you to the NASA spaceflight team working hard behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.